All right, we're about to dive into a very controversial subject. That is, who makes the best bow, and which bow is it? For the most part, it's a matter of opinion, but you have to look at all the variables and decide what you're looking for in a bow. Now, what I'm about to say, with my opinion, kind of comes to short draw bows. Because I'm about 27 and a half inch drawing. I can shoot 28, I can shoot 27. With this bow, I choose to shoot 28. I hate to say it, but even with the advances in archery and everything, most manufacturers don't really cater to people with short draw lengths, except for Bowtech. This is BTX 28. They took pretty much everything from the BTX 31, all the technology and whatnot, and made a short draw bow. You can get short draw bows from other companies, but it's mainly a kid's or woman's bow. No offense to women, but that's kind of how they're labeled. BTX, man's bow, short man. One that you can still do good with, get good speed, good penetration. All right, I'm gonna kind of give you the specs on my setup. Course, like I said, Bowtech BTX 28. Currently on 67 pounds, shooting 450 grain, full bell jacket, and going 300 feet per second. Now, that's one of the reasons I like this bow and like it a lot more than some of the other bows I've shot, which include Matthews, shot Hoyts, shot PSEs. So with that being said, I do have some experience with the new bows. I haven't shot all the new bows, but I have shot a number of them. This one just suits me best. When I started bow hunting, I had a Martin. I liked it. Granted, I was shooting about a 300 grain arrow, and it was only going 240 feet per second. But it still killed deer. Did a pretty good job at it. Now, I wouldn't always get full penetration, and anything past 30 or 40 yards, I really had to have a pretty good pin gap, which that's a subject in its own. When I look at a bow, I try to find the best balance between arrow weight and speed. People say speed doesn't matter, but it does, because there's a big difference between a 600 grain arrow going 250 feet per second and a 600 grain arrow going 150 feet per second. Big penetration difference, big arc, the way the arrow flies, big difference in that. But needless to say, with this bow, 450 grain arrow, 300 feet per second. I do sacrifice a little bit on the draw, because it is a little less forgiving bow, a little harder to draw compared to like the new Tri-Ax or even the RX-1. It's a little smoother on the draw than this, but you sacrifice speed. Now, I've always strived for 300 feet per second. And I found that with this bow. 300 feet per second, 450 grain arrow. You have a fairly heavy arrow, and it's moving pretty fast. It's a pretty comfortable bow to shoot. Like I said, the draw is kind of rough, but it's manageable, and you can get used to it. It's definitely not something to turn you away from this bow. It has the power discs, so if you want a smoother draw, you can put it in comfort setting. And it makes a big difference. It makes it a lot smoother, a lot easier to draw, and a little easier to shoot. But in performance, it's nothing to be scared of. You can manage it. Now, you shoot this bow with the right sight, with the right rest, with the right stabilizer, I believe it'll outshoot any other bow made. But with that being said, if you decide to throw everything I've said out the window, that's perfectly fine, because bow hunting, it's a matter of personal preference. What I like might be different than what you like. I won't take anything away from any other bow manufacturers. I've shot the Tri-Ax. It's smooth as butter. It's probably one of the smoothest bows I've shot. I've shot the NoCam. I was disappointed in it because it really didn't have the performance I was looking for. I haven't shot the RX-1, but I have shot the Carbon Spider Turbo, which, as far as settings and everything, is pretty close to the RX-1. I've shot the Nitrum Turbo, which I liked it, and it had performance, but it also had a really hefty price tag, which this bow, brand new, was $859 after taxes and all. So for $859, and this was new, it was on the cheaper side as far as new performance bows come. And Bowtech usually does pretty good about being budget friendly. Well, more budget friendly than some of the other companies and their flagship bows. This bow suits me well. It might not suit you. Go test all your bows. Find one that does what you want it to do and that is comfortable for you. Now, if you want performance, and you want penetration and speed and a lot of adjustability, and you are a short draw person, I'd check out the BTX 28. You might be able to find them new some places, and you probably find them fairly reasonably priced used. Don't count any of the other ones out, shoot them too. But for performance, you should definitely check this out. And don't let all the Bowtech haters get to you. So y'all have a good one. Just remember, no matter what you do, you gotta practice.